But our Lord does some things that are illogical. obstacle. Sometimes the blessings in our life just don't make no sense. But he says, my ways are not your ways. My thoughts are not your thoughts. So get that mess out your heart. Whatever it is that keeps you from looking on Jesus and looking on his word, get that mess out your heart. That ain't Jesus. That ain't God. But when you truly know that he's the best thing that ever happened to you, you won't let nothing separate you from the love of Jesus Christ. And that brings us directly to our message for the day. We prepared a sermon to preach, and we call it Tear the Roof Off.
Wow.
Tear the Roof Off.
Yeah.
Now, you've heard this story before, I'm sure. In Mark, the Gospel of St. Mark, chapter 2, the story goes that Jesus was in the house preaching. And there was such a large crowd that was following him from house to house and from town to town. In this particular house, there was people crowded all inside the house. There was people crowded all around outside the house. Nobody could even get to the door. People were pushing and shoving just to get to the windows to look inside the house. And there was this man who was sick with cerebral palsy. And he had these friends. He had some good friends because this man couldn't walk. So they picked up his bed and they carried the man to the house where Jesus was in. It was a bed. It might have even been more like a stretcher. And they carried him to the house. And when they couldn't get to the door and they couldn't get to the window, the only thing they could do to get their friend inside to hear the word of God and be blessed, the only thing they could do was climb up on top of the house.
Wow.
They climbed up on top of the house, lifted up this man who's on this stretcher. And then when they got to the top of the house, they ripped a hole in the roof. And with a rope, they let their friend down into the middle of the house. And Jesus looked up and he saw their faith. And they did all of this just so that their friend can be blessed. Have you ever been so blessed you just want your friend to be blessed? Have you ever met Jesus and got to know him so good you just gonna do whatever it takes to make sure somebody else is blessed? I'm trying to tell you, everybody need to have friends like that. Go all out their way to make sure that their friend could get close to Jesus. You know, sometimes when we want to get closer to Jesus, there are just too many things in the way. There are things that try to block our access to Jesus. Sometimes things just even prevent us from getting a prayer through. And there are things sometimes that block you from getting to see the face of the Lord in the midst of your circumstances. And things that try to block you from even experiencing his presence in the midst of your life. Sometimes you end up with a spiritual void, and nothing you seem to do seems to work. You pray, and it seems as if your prayer was not answered. You sing, and you just can't sing the song the way you used to sing the song. You open up the scripture, and it just don't reach out and grab you the way that you expect it to grab you. At some times, you feel hopeless. You feel lonely. You feel that there's something missing in your life. David prayed in Psalm 51 and he said, Lord, please take not thy spirit from me. What you've heard from the Lord, what you've spoken to the Lord, that's something you just don't want to be. You don't want God to take his spirit from you. You don't want the Lord to leave you in hell without a master to fight your battle. You don't want the Lord to leave you. Things that just prevent us from moving up up a little bit higher. It seems as if we've gone as far as we can go and we can't go no further. Sometimes there's a roof. Wow. There's a ceiling. There's a lid that's got us all jarred in and closed in. And no matter what, we can't get closer to God.
Yeah.
We have no more spiritual growth. I'm trying to tell you, I've been there. This Christian journey is about a bunch of ebb and flow.
Wow.
It's about a bunch of ups and downs. It's lots of mountains and valleys. But my heart's desire is to always get closer to Jesus Christ. And whenever there seems to be something blocking me and I can't make that connection, that's when I know in order to get closer to Jesus, in order to get his attention, I got to tear the roof off. I got some uncovering to do. We have to tear the roof off our minds that prevent us from growing in the knowledge of God. You know, some of our past teachings have been flawed. I tell you, sometimes I go through the archives of my old sermons that I scripted and I keep, and I look at it, I be like, what in the world was I thinking? Who said that? Did that come out of my mouth? And I know, thanks be to God that I'm growing today. Because if you look at something you said 10 years ago and it's still relevant today, maybe you need to take a better look at today. Maybe you need to go back and ask God to renew your mind in the name of Jesus Christ. Some things we learned in the past were good for us in the past. But some things we need to learn today. Have you ever tried to teach somebody something and they know? They already know.
They already know.
They already know. You can't get nothing in their head and you can't get nothing out. Mr. Know-it-all. Miss Know-it-all. Can't tell them nothing. Tell them it's cold outside. Oh, it ain't that bad. And boy, it's 10 degrees. You tell them the sun is shining today. Oh, not like it used to back in the day. Some people, you can't even tell them the time of day.
No.
Now, I ain't had that problem like this in this church, but I tell you, I was in a church, and I said some people think that the Bible is one book. I said, the Bible is not one book, it's 66 books. I said, there are 39 in the Old Testament and 27 in the New. Sister said, how you know? Wow. Did you count them?
Wow.
If I can't teach you that, I can't teach you what thus saith the Lord. If I can't teach you little simple earthly things, how you gonna believe if I try to tell you heavenly things? If I can't tell you what's in history that everybody already knows, how can I speak to you a prophecy? How can I tell you what the Lord wants you to know here today? We got to learn. We got to uncover the lid we got on our minds. We got to open our minds. We got to open up our intellect. We got to open up ourselves and let God fill us with new knowledge. Let God fill us with what God wants us to have today. You see, that was the problem with the Pharisees and the Sadducees. They were used to the same old, same old. They were used to business as usual. You all know people who would always say, we've never done it like that before. But Jesus has come to shake up things. Jesus has come to establish a new kingdom. And he's here to make things new every day. But people resist because their minds are already made up. People resist because their minds are already closed. They have a lid on their minds. They got a roof, a ceiling on their minds, and it prevents them from drawing nearer to Jesus. With a closed mind, I said that you can't get nothing in, and you can't get nothing out.
Right.
I mean, you know what ends up happening is we end up stuck on yesterday's news.
Wow.
We end up trying to get a blessing with yesterday's prayer. We end up trying to bless God with yesterday's prayer. But the word of God says all things are new. The word of God says that all things have passed away. The word of God says that the knowledge of the Lord will become life to your soul. Don't be trying to give God yesterday's prayer. Don't be trying to give God yesterday's prayer. Once all things have passed away, yesterday's prayer is a dead prayer. Yesterday's praise is a dead prayer. But the Lord said, new knowledge shall be light unto your soul. New knowledge shall be light to your praise. New life to your prayer. New life to your growth. New life to your soul. You can't bless God with a dead prayer. Dead ought to be buried.
Yeah.
And everything that has life, Sister Thomas, didn't hear that. You heard me right. But I want them to hear that. I like a little back and forth, right? I need you to talk to me so I know you with me, right? So I'm going to do it one more time.
Love her anyway. We
got to know the only way for you to be blessed is for you to forgive somebody for something that they've done to you. Forgive and forget and move on in newness of life. Loving somebody when you hold stuff in and you never let it go, that person had gone on with their life and they ain't even stuck in you. And then you wonder why your prayer ain't working. And then you wonder why new praise is not coming from your lips. We need to tear the roof off our hearts that prevent us from loving like we ought to love. Instead of being happy about somebody else's success, sometimes we just get jealous. Because our hearts ain't right. And you want to know the beauty in this whole thing? No matter what you go through, there's somebody else going through it too. No matter what you go through, somebody else is going through it too. And sometimes when you just open up your mind and you just open up your heart, the problem that you broke out, the one you brought it to, they're already going through it as well. So when you bring it to them, it just becomes confirmation of what they need to do. Sometimes you got to open up your mouth and testify. Amen? And you ain't always got to testify in church. Sometimes you can just pick up the phone and tell somebody about what you're going through and what you're struggling through. And you know what happens? Every time somebody calls me and they tell me something that they're struggling with, it's always me who's struggling with. And I just didn't pick up the phone first. I just didn't pick up the phone first and tell somebody that I was going through. But somebody will call me and they'll speak to me about the very same thing that I'm struggling with. You've got to come to recognize that your life, it ain't about you no more. It's about the goodness of the Lord. It's about being a blessing to somebody else. And when you're willing to uncover and show your soul and expose yourself, you have growth for you and growth for somebody else. But you know what the problem is with both of us? Most of us don't want to be vulnerable. We don't want to expose ourselves. You know, but like, they're shellfish. I mean, like lobsters and crabs and even snakes do the same thing. They call it molting season. And they got to shed those shells, those hard outer exteriors. They got to shell those things and get out of that because they can't grow when they're stuck in that same old shell. But when they come up out of it, that's when they're most vulnerable to predators. That's when they're most vulnerable to be eaten alive. That's when they're most vulnerable to be hurt and destroyed. So some of us, we just don't want to be hurt. So we don't want to tell nobody nothing because we think preacher might preach about it. Or we don't want to tell nobody nothing because we think they might want to share it with somebody else. Well, maybe you need better friends. Or maybe sometime you just need to realize that maybe the preacher ain't preaching about you. He's preaching about himself. Amen? I had Pastor Sapo. I had a pastor, and every other week he preached about adultery. And every other week he preached about lust. And I used to love going to church. I wanted to hear it. And my father said, recognize what somebody talked about is usually what they're about. If you listen, you hear my sermons, what do you hear? We got to learn to forgive. That's my goal. I hold all this stuff. That's my goal. That's the one that troubles me. That's the one that always comes out of my mouth. But see, it's vulnerability to come out of your face and tell somebody where you struggle It's vulnerability to come out of your face and tell somebody the things that trouble you and then the sin that you have in your life that keeps you from being really holy and really righteous. But you see, the shellfish, when they come up out of it, that's the only way they're going to grow. That's the only way they're going to learn. Sometimes you just got to trust the process. Sometimes you won't get hurt, and sometimes you won't get help. Sometimes you won't get pain, and sometimes you won't get progress. But you got to have faith that whatever the Lord brings down your way is going to be worth it in the past. And the beauty in it all is when you really are truly exposing yourself, it ain't just to a friend, it ain't just to a pastor, it ain't just to a counselor, but you are exposing yourself to God. You are saying, God, here I am, this is my problem. God, here I am, this is my trouble. God, I'm trying to tear the roof off so you can see my face. God, I stretch my hands to meet no one to help I know. And let me tell you the beauty in the Lord. Whenever you expose yourself to God, God will expose himself to you. Open up to the Lord. And he says, I open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing. Draw near to God and see if God won't draw near to you. Open up your heart and say, Lord, come into my heart and see if the Lord won't bless you. Expose yourself to the Lord and the Lord will expose himself to you. When the brothers pulled open that roof, Jesus looked up and he saw their faith. And he said unto them, my brothers, your faith has made thee whole. And he says, your sins are forgiven. Amen. He says to the man with the palsy, take up thy bed and go thy way. And everybody started to trouble the Lord. And he was exposed to criticism because he was trying to show that he has the power to forgive sins on earth. So you may be asking, what do we need to do then? What do we need to do to tear the roof off? What do we need to do to open our minds and to open our hearts? The first thing the brothers did was he came to Jesus. That's always the first step. You got to come to the Lord just as you are. You got to come to the Lord without one plea. You got to come to the Lord and say, God, here I am. You got to come to the Lord and say, Lord, I don't feel your spirit like I'm used to feeling your spirit. Lord, I don't see you in the midst of my circumstances. Lord, move me and take me, my God, where you want to be. There ain't nothing you got to do. Too many people talk about, I'm going to join the church as soon as I get my life together. If I waited till I got my life together, I wouldn't be here now. Amen? And if I could have got my life together, it would have never got messed up in the first place. There's some things we need to do for ourselves, but when we come to Jesus, we just need to come. Because you can't wash away your sins. You can't save your own soul. Jesus is our Savior, and we give it to the Lord that the Lord will bless us. They come. They come. They came. And when they came, what they had to do in order to get through, they had to get lifted up. He had to get lifted up to the rooftop. Amen? Sometimes when you come, you got to get lifted. And I ain't trying to talk about nobody. But you ain't getting lifted. Amen. Amen. Sitting like this. When somebody is sitting there harder. You ain't getting lifted. On Facebook. While somebody is singing their heart out. You get lifted when you praise him. You get lifted when you come up out of yourself and glorify his name. I know we don't all praise alike, but then you need to pat your feet a little bit more loudly. You need to rock in your chair just a little bit more. You need to wave your hand. Do something to let the Lord know you in the house. The word, he says, the song says, while on others thou art calling, do not pass me by. Some of y'all will get passed by if you don't learn when to stand on your feet and praise God. Some of y'all will get passed by if you don't know how to clap your hands. Some of y'all will get passed by if you don't know how to worship him in your heart. Some of us are going to get passed by if we don't know how to make a loud, joyful noise unto the Lord. You got to come and get lifted by praising the Lord. You got to come and get lifted by getting down on your knees in prayer. You got to come and get lifted by standing up and offering a testimony to God. You got to come and get lifted because when the praises go up, the blessings come down. You got to come and get lifted, giving God the glory and the honor. I ain't gonna say I didn't warn you. Some of y'all gonna get passed by. They came. They got lifted, right? Nate, I ain't beating no dead horse, right?
No, sir.
No. I want to. You gotta come. You gotta get lifted. And then you got to be willing to expose yourself. Sometimes I just wonder, are we afraid to praise him because somebody might look? Are we afraid to shout hallelujah because somebody might hear? Are we afraid? Are we ashamed? I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ because it is the power to salvation. It's the power to give God the glory. It takes power to praise the name of the Lord. You got to come. You got to get lifted. And you got to be willing to expose yourself. Because when you expose yourself to Jesus, Jesus will expose himself to you. And he will show you who he really is. He will show you how he's been there with you the whole time. He will show you how he already brought you through. Stand on your feet, we're done. We give God the praise. We give him the glory. We give him God. We got to learn to tell the truth. We got to learn to open up our hearts. We got to learn to open up our mouths. We got to learn to open up our minds and allow the Lord to bless us and to give us the blessings that he has just for us. Gracious God, in Jesus' name, we thank you, Lord, for the power of prayer. We thank you, Lord, for the power of praise. And we thank you, Lord, for the power of our faith that shows us, my God, that we can overcome everything when we trust you, when we believe in you, when we come to you, when we get lifted in praise, and when we expose our lives to be blessed by you. So thank you, God, in Jesus' name, that we might keep the ceiling, the jar head, the roof, that we might keep the lid off, my God, that you might be able, God, to use us the way you want to use us. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. The doors